Hello guys, it's Ben Emmanuel here once again. In this video, what I'm going to do is show you how to create a subdomain on a VPS server. Remember, it's not just any kind of subdomain, it's going to be on a VPS server. So we're manually doing everything by hand by ourselves. Let's see, I think I have VPS, I have my server already created on DigitalOcean, and I have this domain goaccess.com.ng pointing to this server. It's an Ubuntu server, Ubuntu 20.4, I guess. I can't remember. So I think it's Ubuntu 20.4, and this is my domain. So I'm gonna click on this here, and let's open a new tab, and then I want to type in I want to try to access this domain. So let's say I'm creating a domain called dashboard.goaccess.com.ng. If you look here, you see that our browser can actually not find this server at all because there's nothing for that. And so what I want to do is create it. And down here, if you look here, you know, I moved here, and if you look here, you see that we have some subdomains like API, admin, and so on. And so I want to create a new one, and this is where you create a new record. So it's actually called a record, and there are different types of records here, but what we want to create is an A record. And then this is going to be the host name is going to be dashboard. So dashboard, and if you look down here, you see that automatically it has created this dashboard.com.ng, and this is because that is our domain name, that is our main domain. And then we now need to tell it where we want it to point the domain to, the domain we're creating to, and that's going to be our Ubuntu server with this IP address. And I'm going to click on create, and it's going to create it down here for me. And then I need to create another one, which is going to be www.dashboard, which is going to be our alias, and then point it to the same Ubuntu server. And now it has been created for me. Now, because we created this, doesn't mean that we can actually go to the web page and then try to access this page and it's going to work fine. It's not going to work fine. What we need to do next is configure our server to allow this work as we expect it to work. Now, the thing here is we are now creating a new folder where a different application is supposed to live, and maybe an application called dashboard is supposed to live in for this website. And so I'm going to open up this server on you can actually use any IDE, but I'm going to use VS Code, and I'm going to connect via SSH. So I'm going to connect to a remote SSH server, and this is what I need to do here. I think I have it configured here, so I just click on this and then input my password, and after my password I should have access to the server. Come on. All right, so now I have access to the server, and I need to access a part where I will do all of my configurations. And so I will go to the top here, open a new folder, and this folder is going to be located at /etc/apache2, and that's because this server is built on Apache. Using Apache. So if you have Nginx installed on your own server, then the configuration is going to be completely different, which means this video isn't for you. If you actually want to learn how to do it with Nginx, then you need to make a request. I am going to make that video on request. And now here I have this folder open here, the Apache 2 folder open here, and I'm not going to bother about any other folder or file that is actually here on display. Instead, what I want to focus more on is the sites available folder and the sites enable. Here, this is where you create, this is where you tell the server, hey, these are the websites that I want available on this machine, and then this is where you now tell it, hey, these are the sites that I want to enable. So you can actually create a site and not even enable it at all, and your users are not going to be able to access this site. And then if you enable it, then the users should be able to access it. So if we open this folder, you see that we have a couple of domain configuration files here, one for admin, another one for API, and then the main configuration file here. These are actually enabled. If you try to visit this website, it's going to open up fine as expected. But if you delete any of this file, this configuration file, then the sites are not going to be, the sites you deleted isn't going to be enabled at all. So here we're going to create a new folder here, because this is where we want to tell our server that, hey, we want this guide to be available so that our users can just type in dashboard.gotaccess.com.ng and then access the website. So here we're going to create a configuration for our website. So it's going to be dashboard.goaccess.com.ng .conf for configuration, and this is going to open up here. This is our new file here, and I think what I want to do, I don't want to write all of these configurations all over again. So what I'm going to do here is I'll just copy one of the configurations we have here and then paste it here and then do some modifications to it. Now this is a virtual host. The virtual host is the guide now tells our server that, hey, there's a different application that lives somewhere, probably here. This is the part, so var www is where all applications live, and so you're now telling it like this is the root directory or root document. This is where you can actually find the application whenever a user visits the goaccess.com.ng. So now we're going to change this, because now we want it to point to dashboard.goaccess.com.ng, and so what I'm going to do here is I will just add I'll just add the prefix here in front of this. So I'm adding the prefix, so it's going to be dashboard.goaccess.com.ng, and that should be it. So this is our domain name, this is the alias we created sooner, and then this is the path to the application that we want to serve to the user. And every other thing you see here, just extra configurations that I have done, and none of these configurations are required, but we actually need to have them for some reasons. If you want to know why I'm having them here, then please make a request in the comment section. And this code we're having here, I'm going to delete this code because it has to do with SSL, which we don't actually have right now. So we're just deleting the code, and then this is us. This is how simple the code is going to look like. Now, the next thing you need to do is enable the site. But before I enable the site, what I would want to do is create this directory so that our application would have the directory. So I'm going to log into the server on a different window. Oh, please don't be this big. So I want to open the path to where my applications are supposed to live. So on a, I'm assuming that you already know all of these things because these are basic stuffs. I mean, where the application is supposed to live on the server and stuff like that. And so on an Apache server, the site is supposed to live here, where we have the var slash www. This is where all sites are supposed to live, and that's why you see I have different folders here for each of the sites I have already on this app, on this server. So now I'm going to create a new a new folder, and this folder is going to be here like this. So to var/dashboard.goaccess.com.ng. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new folder, and that's going to be dashboard.goaccess.com.ng/public.html, and that's going to create two folders for me, so one here and this other one here. And the public HTML is where our application is supposed to live, or our website is supposed to live. So like index.html, I could just make index.php and it's still going to work fine, or I can just compile, build my React application and then upload the React application here, and it's still going to work perfectly fine. So I'm just going to create a little boilerplate here for the website so that we can actually test that this thing actually works. And let's say dashboard for the title and then h1. Hey, it worked. It worked. So if we see this page on the web page when we hit the refresh button here, it means our configurations and everything worked fine. At this point, we don't expect the configurations to actually work fine, because like I told you before, now this is where you let the server knows that hey, a website is available, and then this is where you let the server knows that hey, a website is enabled and should be allowed access to. But at this point, if you look here, you'll see that we don't have the dashboard.goaccess.com.ng here. So how do we now have it there? And the way to do this is to open up your terminal, which you can actually do by going to terminal and then new terminal. This is going to open up, or you just use the shortcut control and then backtick is the key before one on your keyboard. So here I'm going to type this command, sudo apache 2 enable site, and then the name of the site is dashboard.goaccess.com.ng. And if I press enter, that's going to enable the site for me. And then the next thing it says is to activate this, we need to activate the new configuration we added, we need to run this command. And what this command does is it restarts or reloads our Apache server. So I'm just going to go ahead and type it myself instead of copying it up, so that I learn how to do it, or my memory sticks, or this thing, the command sticks to my memory, so I can always do it myself without even looking anywhere or referencing it anywhere, or even trying to Google it. That's just the best way to learn. So what I'm going to do here is restart the server rather than reload it, because for some reasons, I don't know, after reloading it still doesn't work. So I'm going to restart the server. If it comes back like this without any error or any warning, then everything works fine. So what we need to do here is try to refresh this to see if it worked, or it didn't work, it hasn't worked yet. So we're just going to give it some time, because in most cases it's going to take some time for it to actually work. Now it's not going to take any much time, but I will just pause this video, and then when it works I'll continue from where I stopped. All right, yeah, it worked. So as you can see here, we now have dashboard.goaccess.com.ng, which is our subdomain, working perfectly fine. Like I told you, if it worked out fine, then the whatever application you put in that directory is going to work fine. So let's say I put my name here, and then we go back here and I refresh the page. You can see that it's grabbing this content directly from our server. And I think the next thing we would want to do is see how we can defeat this not secure thing you're seeing here at the top of this. This is telling us that our website isn't secure because we don't have any SSL for this. It's not that we don't have any SSL on our server. We do have an SSL on the server, but the SSL doesn't know, or probably our configuration doesn't tell the the browser that this is where our SSL certificate is, or get the SSL certificate and then use it for this subdomain. And there's nothing like that to fix the problem. So we're going to fix the problem. And for us to fix this problem, we're going to use catbot. You can actually find catbot here. So if you visit this, you should be able to access catbot if you visit this page here. And this is where you can learn how to install your catbot, because this is the official documentation. So you can learn how to install catbot and then install an SSL certificate, or create an SSL certificate for your website directly from here. So I'm going to use this to create an SSL certificate, although we already have one. It's going to tell us here we have one. If you don't know how to do all of this, the installation of catbot on your server, just make a request in the comment section below and I'm going to show you how to do all of this. And the command I want to run is this one, where you get to do sudo catbot --  apache. I'm going to run it here and it will tell me, hey, you already have something. Oh, okay, so it's asking me a question. Which name would you like to activate SSL for, HTTPS for? And you can see I have all of the websites here, and it's now saying I should leave the input blank. I don't need to input anything here if I wanted to select all for me. All. So yeah, I wanted to select all for me, and that's because I've had bad experience specifically targeting the SSL41 instead of all. So, and now we now say, yeah, there's an existing certificate containing some of these, and yeah, so. These are the domain names that we actually built that certificate for previously before now. And now it's saying, if we are requesting a new certificate, it's going to be created for all of these domain names that we have in here, including the new domain that we just created. So if you look here, it shows us all the domain names that the previous certificates were created for. You'd find out that the previous certificate wasn't designed or created for the dashboard.goaccess.com, but the new one we want to create is going to be for that. And do we want to expand or replace the old certificate? Please, let's expand the new certificate. So I'm going to press E and then it's going to expand the old certificate to now accommodate the new domain name. So it's going to just add the new domain name to the previous certificates that we had. And once this is all done, all right, so one more thing, redirect all traffic from HTTP to HTTPS. Yes, that's exactly what we want to do. So I'm going to take the option 2 and then press Enter. And everything is done. So congratulations, we now have our certificate. And if we go to our configuration here, you can now see that we created this configuration file, and automatically because of the SSL, we now have another configuration file which should now handle the SSL port for us and everything. And it has just copied the configurations we wrote previously and then added it here, and then maybe added a couple of lines for us just to point to wherever our certificate is. And this is exactly what we want. And if you go back to dashboard.goaccess.com.ng, which is the initial certificate we created, you'd see that it has added this line, the one we removed sooner. Like I told you, this line is just going to enforce the SSL for us. It's just going to make sure that it redirects our user to our SSL websites rather than the non-SSL version of it. So if I refresh, you should see that we now have the no secure, not secure label gone. So we now have the lock here. So thank you for watching this video. And I appreciate you. If you like this video, please give a like to the video. and subscribe to the video, to my channel, so that you stay updated whenever I post new videos to the channel.